I look at what has really worked for you in the last five, I mean, I guess from 2003 to 2007 and in the last 5 years, is really the consumer-oriented stocks, whereas the other ones haven't really worked well for you. Is that a fair comment?
No, ma'am. There are a lot of stocks in which I book profit also. Hmm. Great Eastern, Bharat Electronics, Bharat Earth Movers, Praj, I sold a large part of my portfolio, large part. So those will not be reflected today. Hmm. But they are all in which the gains has already been booked.
Right, right.
So I have had my fair level of mistakes and fair sense of far more than people think and know.
Mm-hmm.
But I think what has really worked for me are three stocks.
Hmm.
Titan, Lupin and Crisil. I think they are a very, very good part of my portfolio, maybe more than 50%,
mm-hmm.
or even more than 55%. And they have really, and tight, all of them are at, you know, lifetime highs.
Mm-hmm.
Despite the index being where it is, they are far above the prices of 2000, highs of 2007-2008. In fact, Titan's high was 160. Today the price is, no, it was not worth 160, 80 rupees effectively. Today the price is 240. Similarly, Lupin is 2 to 3 times its 2007-8 high. And also a lot of the stocks that where I made very good money, I remember 3-4 of them, Bharat Electronics, Bharat Earth Movers, Praj partly, Great Eastern,
mm-hmm.
I have totally sold them.
Whether you look at Titan or you look at Lupin or Crisil, they're still what you call the defensive sectors and are focused on the domestic consumption story. But generally speaking, the sector is quite expensive and the valuations are more in these sectors where there's no growth. Ma'am, what's your view on that?
Ma'am, you know why I'm so bullish on Titan even today?
Mm-hmm.
The price has gone from 40 to 4900. Nobody has come and told me one that we must buy Titan. So, what is expensive and what is not expensive? I think as long as Titan has 20-25% growth and his return on equity exceeds 30-35%
mm-hmm.
and operational cash flows is equal to profits, I think its PE will survive.
Hmm.
You know, Hindustan Lever has remained expensive for a lifetime, but it has remained.
So you still think that these expensive stocks will remain expensive and there's still more opportunity?
What I personally think is that the gain in them will be limited to earnings growth. There cannot be re-rating of PEs now.
Mm-hmm.
The PE is expanded to what it could be, right? And therefore, if they grow 15-20%, my portfolio, co-portfolio grows at 20%, I'm extremely happy.
Mm-hmm. So now in the banking sector, which is also indirectly like a domestic consumption story, I notice you only have one bank, Karur Vysya Bank.
No, I also have Federal Bank.
Okay, okay.
But Karur Vysya Bank has, I think, invested 50 lakhs in 93, today it's more than 200 crores.
Wow.
So that's the kind of return Karur Vysya Bank has given.
Wow.
I see no reason it's growing at 18-20%. It's good management, rewarding shareholders, good yield. I think 400 is the price, I think 16 rupees is the dividend.
Mm-hmm.
So 4 rupees, 4% yield. And so therefore, I don't trust the public sector banks.
Mm-hmm.
And second thing is, see, I have one limitation. I don't want to invest less than 50 to 100 crores in a script.
Mm-hmm.
Firstly, I don't have that kind of money to invest. And second is that even if I have that money, the liquidity is not there.
Mm-hmm.
So it's difficult to build positions.
So it's not like you don't like the banking sector. You have liquidity constraints and you don't like PSUs.
Yes.
But Federal Bank you like as well.
Yeah, and I have substantial investment in both mm-hmm. of them. They will be still about, banking will be 70% of my portfolio.
Mm-hmm. Now, I also read that you don't like the IT sector in general, but then you're buying Geometric. Every day we hear you're buying Geometric. So what makes you change your view towards Geometric, but you don't like the IT sector?
No, it's not that I don't like the IT sector. See, the Geometric has got there is going to be a big boom in engineering services. And last quarter, Geometric has performed very well.
Mm-hmm.
So if it continues that performance, it's an extremely cheap stock.
Okay. So it's the valuation. So the mid-cap IT, or I guess you're liking more the IT companies that are going the engineering or capitalizing on the engineering.
The PLM services.
Okay.
Geometric is a very specialized player. And they have had good improvement in margins. And I think they're making some efforts to improve margins. I think that should work out.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Another stock that's very interesting I saw in your portfolio is this Delta Corp. I think it's one of the only gaming or very few gaming companies in India. Now, if I look at Malaysia,
there is only one.
Yeah, and I look at Macau, those companies have done exceedingly well and are very expensive, in terms of price earnings multiples. And Delta, of course, I'm not able to get a lot of information, but it looks, is that a theme, part of your theme?
Is
that the re-rating?
It is a play on consumption in India.
Mm-hmm.
And that, there are four new projects opening up in the next 3 months. I'm extremely bullish on Delta.
Hmm.
I myself love to gamble a lot. And it's a legitimate gambling, and I mean, I'm bullish on Dell now.
Looking at some of the other infrastructure sectors where, of course, the government is trying to increase in, you know, India needs investment to increase and for its GDP to grow. But this sector, which, you know, whether it's power or roads or infrastructure related, that sector has languished. Is that a sector, I know you have some investments, are you looking to add, or are you just sort of pretty much disappointed with this way the sector has behaved?
Well, I bought some shares of Nagarjuna Constructions.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know, I could add, I may not add.
Mm-hmm.
Difficult to say.
Mm-hmm.
But surely it's a very beaten down sector, and I feel from these levels in a period of 2-3 years should give very good returns.